We're almost there, so I guess it's time to start slowing down a little bit. How do we do that? I guess I should try using the brakes. Oh. Dang. I wonder if I can save it.
The same technology that allows our satellites to communicate across the cosmos also allows us to send tiny photons of information fumbling into the bright box you're staring at now, broadcasting the greatest thing since sliced bread. With this technology, you'll be able to watch Shimmy launch a rocket into space 15 seconds shy of live. Shimmy's Space Quest, every Tuesday, 9 p.m. Eastern, 8 p.m. Central, only on KSP TV.
Hello, my name is Matoro Ignika, and I do lots of things. As you can see, I do some crazy things, some interesting things, and well, things like this. All according to plan, right? If you want to see more, then you can catch my show every Saturday at 8 p.m. Eastern, 7 p.m. Central, and 1 a.m. GMT right here on KSP TV.
Join me, Mitch, for Start the Week on KSP TV. Mondays, 3 p.m. EST, 8 p.m. BST, 11 p.m. MSK, and 5 a.m. AET.
Hello, hello, hello! Welcome back to another broadcast of Shimmy's Space Quest, where though planning is useless, planning is essential to our cause, which is to quest into space. I'm your host, Shimmy. How's everybody doing today? Also, it's quiet. Why is it so quiet? Hi, peeps! Ipeer, Gav, Dane, Make One B, Sam Carr. Let's see here. Random Tank. Casper! Hey, Casper. Tabakase. Did I forget anybody? DJ! And others. Teflon Mike. Is Teflon Mike here? No, Teflon Mike isn't here. Hello, R. Bremer. Kivo. Average Size Midget. Daring! Steven. So, yeah, I'm still waiting for the game to load there, as you can see. I'm a little tired today. I don't know why. I got up a little earlier than I normally do. And then I went out. I went outside. I went to this place called Outside. It's a very interesting place. Because the temperature was very pleasant. It was overcast, so no direct sunlight. I just sat out there waiting for a package for about over an hour or so. But I feel kind of drained, so I'm just kind of like, ugh. But anyway, we must go on. We do have a plan. It's essential to our cause, which is to play Kerbal Space Program and all other various things. So yeah, let's go ahead and resume. So as we have been playing, we did land a base module on the surface of Minmus. And we are planning on returning that back into orbit. But I just remembered yesterday, I just out of the blue, I was like, oh yeah, I forgot to redock a very specific, a very important piece of equipment. The tug is just floating out there next to Minmus space station. And so we're going to need to do that first. Let's go ahead and squish my head here. Hello, Zergot. Oh god. Oh god, no, a plan! Yeah, my plans are, I call them plans, but, you know, we don't know about how they are. So, yep, let's go ahead and go right to it here. I might not stream for very long today, considering I just got a new computer case, and got all the other computer hardware sitting in my room on the floor over there. I am really antsy to start putting it together, but, you know, so I am still playing on my old crappy computer. We will have one more. One more stream with it at least, maybe two, if something doesn't go right. Let's go over to No IO Depot. This says it's a probe. I believe it's the Tug. I don't believe we had a name for the Tug. Did we have a name for the Tug? I don't know what it was. So, let's go and fly it. It says QLS 46 probe. It's just a Tug. It's a space Tug. Let's go to my notes here. And where's my files? Did I name it anything? Did I name it the Polaris or something? It was the Polaris Tug, I think. The anticipation. Yeah, it's rather scary considering. You know, it's putting a computer together. I've done it. I've put computers together for years. You know, it's not something I normally do, but you know, I've for years and years I've done it for either me or other people, and you know, it's that anxiety of, you know, what if just something goes entirely wrong and everything's ruined, you know? Because back in the day, sometimes when you're, you know, learning to put computers together, you get something wrong, everything wasn't so idiot-proof, and you might fry something, you might plug in something wrong, and you don't know how to fix it. These days, not as big of a deal, but still. Hello, John Wayne Props. Hello, Jerry Pick. Hello, Rapa Frombage. Hello, Grugrox, how's it going? So what we're going to do here, we're just going to go ahead and burn towards the station. It's going to be a little inefficient, honestly. Actually, which way are we going? Let's go ahead and kill our relative velocity first, and then we'll go ahead and just kind of drift towards it. We are 6 kilometers away. So I think if we do something kind of like this, maybe get us up to 20 meters a second, we might be doing the right thing here. Am I running many hertz today? Nope, not yet. Just got the case earlier today. I was waiting outside, the very scary place. Got the case. Now I'm just... got to do a stream, and I'll be putting it together later. I don't know if I'll have it ready for tomorrow, but, you know, I'm gonna try. You also may or may not have hurt your processor today, giving it too many volts. Uh-oh, that's not good. That's no good. Alright, so we are just 3 kilometers out, not too far. Just gonna go ahead and bring this up just a little bit. You're probably gonna buy 16 grab later this month. Yep, that's how much I got. Just DDR3 1600 or whatever. I was thinking I'd overclock it, but I was like, nah, I don't even really need to worry about that, honestly. I don't think that's going to be a problem. So 1600 it is. So, yep, that's what we do. We're now approaching the station again. We have plenty of Delta V to deal with this. We have 4,000. And after we go ahead and get this thing docked, we'll go ahead and talk about returning the base module back up to the station, too. Also, thank you, Casper. Appreciate that. I am streaming on KSPTV today. I also do stream on my channel multiple times a week. And Casper put the link there. So how far are we at? We are 1-point-something kilometers away. Oh! Well. That was... How did that happen? I must have hit it too many times. Alright, so... Yeah, that happened. That's probably the weirdest thing. I don't know how I did that, but... It was in Time Warp, so even if we did collide to the station, we wouldn't have collided into the station, right? Alright, so yeah. Alright. Let's go ahead and bring it back here. Bring it up to, 4 kilometers. 4 kilometers a second? No, 4 meters a second. I seem out of it today. I might be a little out of it today. Alright, just gonna go ahead and increase my energy while decreasing my attention. That always will work, right? Okay, we are time warping. Now we need to figure out where we're gonna dock this thing. Probably want to dock it to this side. And the LLV will dock it on the port opposite of this side, I think. Still tired from the marathon stream? Yeah, maybe it took more out of me than I thought it would. Also, we are probably going a little bit too fast now. Let's go ahead and start slowing down. Let's go ahead and slow down. Slow down. Please slow down. Also, that's the wrong direction. Slow down. Okay, I'm not slowing down fast enough, so I'll just go ahead and use main engines here. Okay. This tug sacks. I need more RCS on it. Okay, so we are here. We need to be there. So we'll just go ahead and just kind of into place. We might need to go ahead and retract a couple of our solar panels so we can prevent breakage of them. Let's go ahead and retract these panels here too. And go ahead and set this as a target. And we'll point in the right direction and we'll just kind of translate over there. Make a third design? Isn't this the third? Do I need to make a fourth? I think all I'd really need to do is add more RCS to it, I think is all I'd really need to do. I wonder if I could cheat scale these things to be a little bit larger so they could provide more oomph. I wonder if that would be a good idea. You irradiated you? You're fine, don't worry about it. You're in here somewhere, right, Dane? Cheats, yes. Something tells me that you guys actually love the cheats. You really just love the cheats. Also, why is the solar panel not... Where's the sun? Is the sun invisible? What does it say? Blocked by Minmus. Okay. Why do we have so much sunlight, though? Is Minmus, like, shining sunlight? Like, is it being refracted through its ice layers or something like that? You hate cheats? You got rad poisoning. You got rad poisoning. because it's so rad, you know? You're awesome. If the Anti-Cheat Council would not... Yeah, right. Okay. No, that is not the key I want to hit. The angle bracket key does not make me go to the left or the right. We're getting there. I'm going to go ahead and approach the station. Slowly. There we go. Come on. Come on. Okay, approaching at 0.6, maybe a little bit too high, but I think we'll be okay for now. We'll go ahead and translate. It's a little bit more. Yep. Looks like everything's gonna be okay here, even though the station's kind of in a weird position. Might not be getting all the sunlight we want. Okay. No. Okay. Let's go ahead and fix that. Let's go ahead and slow down. Alright, 0.3. We're looking good. Okay. Go ahead and double hand this. I can't tell. Are we close? Yeah, we're close. Okay. And... wow! That was actually no bounce or anything like that. Looking good. But, oh, yeah, the sun's right there. Why does it say that it was blocked? It's one of those things that's like, oh, well, if it's... I don't know, it's weird. It's some sort of glitch. Now, let's see if we can go ahead and get this thing pointed kind of more in the right direction. And this might be a little funny, but we're going to go ahead and try it, because currently the solar panel's not doing a single thing. So if we went ahead and controlled from there, maybe if we can just go ahead and rotate, no... come on, control from here. Thank you. Okay. I'm doing something. Let's go ahead and use SAS. Maybe that'll help us. Rotate around. Well, that's no problem, Captain. GRT. Really appreciate that. I'm glad I can help. I really don't see how I can help, because it seems like I'm so scatterbrained and I don't really calm anyone or anything like that. But I'm glad. I am happy to hear that. So if you are happy, then I am happy. Shimi, what exactly are you doing, planning? Do I need to fill out the form? Okay, so right now I'm still kind of playing a little cleanup here. What I am doing is I just went ahead and docked the tug because I kind of forgot about it and it was just kind of sitting here in orbit not doing anything. And I need to dock it back up to the station. So we went ahead and took care of that. Now we're going to go back down to the surface of Minmus at Zog's base, and we are going to decouple the station. Decouple the base. We're going to refuel the tug. And then return it back to the station here. So that's what we're going to go and do next. Let's go ahead and switch to this. What? That's not what I wanted. That's a nothing. Alright. Switch to the Brover. Thank you. Yeah, I'm definitely off today, Ipier says. Yeah, I just feel kind of tired. I don't know. So, yeah, maybe I just don't have... I wish I had a Capcom today, but I don't. That's no problem, though. Let's go ahead and continue here. We're just going to play some Kerbal Space Program today. Just, you know, just do our thing. You know, I do have plans. So we know what we're going to be doing. It's just... I don't know exactly how I'm going to do it, but, you know, I know what I'm going to try and do, at least. So, yeah. Yep. Okay, so we got Chronic Offender Kerman. He is the Kerbal that went ahead and flew this thing down. He was an awful pilot, I'm sorry to say. Bouncing and jumping all over the place. Also, what did we forget about this thing? We needed lights. And I was thinking about actually switching to a different set of... what are those things called? SAS modules. Yes, I did, Raider Nick. I absolutely did. Okay. So those are there. Let's go ahead and... Oh, wait a second. this has fuel in it. You can't live in a habitation module with fuel in it. You can't do that. All right, let's go ahead and fix that. Procedural fuel tank. Let's go ahead and transfer out. And transfer out. There we go. I think we're all good. There we go. And undock, please. And it slowly just touches down on the surface. Very, very nice. Okay. Do you have the thing running that lets us look at live game data? Yeah, I believe we can get that set up here. I don't remember the website that it switched to. What is it? I don't remember what it was. It was... Oh, found it. Okay. I'm gonna ask Ipier to do something here for me in a second. Or Raider Nick. When he peeps. Well, Ipier has mod privileges in this channel. Just like that. Go ahead and take this. Make sure it works. Nope. Oh, wait. I need to spell things correctly. We got telemetry here, altitude, yep, okay, that information matches. Ipier, if you could make a tiny URL of this link, I'd really appreciate it for people to know. There we go. So hopefully we'll go ahead and get that taken care of. Thanks, buddy. Really appreciate it. All right, Chronic Fender, now you need to go ahead and do some work here. On here, Jimmy, I think, I don't think so, Dane. I don't think you are. I would really remember that. Well, don't tell him that, Cantab. He might take advantage. Let's go ahead and grab it. It's a tarp. Yep. I think we're going to be close enough for this thing to work, but we're still a little ways away, unfortunately. Alright, so we're going to go ahead and bring this here. So that should be good. Watch the solar panels. Now we're going to go ahead and take one of these ports and attach it to that piece right there. Unfortunately, we didn't land in the perfect spot, so... let's go ahead and grab. And attachy-do. And wait, no, don't grab. Attachy do, please. Just go ahead and can we F5? Yes, we can F5. We F5 right above the solar panels. That was a great thing to do. Let's go ahead and link. And link. And linked. Alright, so now what we can do is use the mine device here to refuel the ship before we take it back up into orbit. Good job, Chronic. Alrighty, cool. Very, very cool. So now we can go into... Actually, I think everything's still running. Is this still running? Yes, it is. So all we need to do is just wait for this thing to refill back up, and then we'll be good to go. Let's see. We go ahead and do a oxidizer, liquid fuel, and then go ahead and balance all on all these. There we go. And then just wait for the entire thing to fill up here. Might take a few hours. Actually, it didn't take that long at all. So that filled up, that filled up. That's not connected, so that's good. Okay. Alrighty. Okay. Okie day. This is good, this is good. Also, I was in time warp for maybe a little bit too much. So that wasn't good. Down here for 7 hours. So it took a little while. A little bit longer than it does take like a Texaco or something like that. But we are completely filled up. Okay, and those actually are now updated properly. So here we go. So let's go ahead and get Chronic back out. We need to have him unlink that pipe, and then we'll be sending him back into orbit around Minmus. Oop. Come on. Come on. Because we do have a HAB module here, but it doesn't have any of the service module stuff to it, like power, life support, or anything. So that will need to be brought down in a later mission. So the base is making progress, but it isn't ready to be lived here yet. But as soon as we do, we'll go ahead and send some Kribbles down here to live, pretty much semi-permanently. I was just about to say semi-permeability. But that was not the terminology I was hoping to use. Have you left Kribble attachment system struts on the base that might serve you better reattaching stuff to your lander? Well, I have these Kribble attachment system struts here, and it would be best to store them away. Thing is, I don't have a place to store them. But But as you remember, how my current tug kind of sacks, what I can do is kind of siphon off these struts here and actually use them to kind of band-aid the wobbly issue with the tug. So I'm going to go ahead and just grab these, just kind of store them somewhere for later use. Even though I don't have a storage system, you can always just store something just by grabbing it. So I'll just go ahead and store them like... why can't I control this guy? Okay, there we go. Store them like right over here. There we go. Oh, what'd I do? Hit the keys on my player there. Let's go ahead and grab. The cheat drive? Oh! Yeah, that was on EJ's stream. EJ does a thing where people can submit payloads for him to launch on his shuttles, and I went ahead and submitted a sort of proprietary prototype drive. Basically what I created was a Kraken drive. A Kraken drive meaning a device that basically can create thrust without using any sort of propellant or anything like that. It basically uses a game glitch to do it, but it was kind of fun. We didn't really explain exactly what it was until he released it and then activated it, and everybody was like, "Whoa!" Yeah, that was a fun reaction. I was expecting somebody to call me out immediately as soon as I posted the press kit, but nobody did. At least I didn't see anybody do it, so you know. That was pretty fun too, making the press kit. I might want to do that again in the future, submit another one in the future, but probably not this next 2 months. I'll wait for the next time around. Kraken drive, yep. A Kraken drive. Basically uses a game glitch to create thrust. In the stock game. So bear with me here. What I'm doing right now is just grabbing all these struts. I believe I only need 8. I do have some on the bottom too, but I think I'm just going to go ahead and ignore those. I've already got enough here. 8 should be enough, I think, to resolve the wobbly issue. If not, then I seriously need to consider just launching another tug, which I'm probably going to need to do eventually because this one does not have enough RCS ports, or at least not enough RCS thrust. So. Phantom forces generating thrust. Yep, using the landing leg trick. Basically, landing legs colliding with the body or the spacecraft that it is attached to can cause some interesting effects. I use the medium-sized landing legs, kind of colliding a docking port. That's the only way I figured out how to do it reliably. They added a new Steam feature called broadcasting. That's not fair. I'm the one that invented broadcasting. Along with sliced bread. Alright, we're almost here, guys. We are almost here. Let's go ahead and get this, reattach, and then we'll be good to go there. It's perfect. Alright, so... Oh, almost had a EVA propellant. He used a lot there. That would have been a problem. I think it would have been possible to get back in the vessel without EVA propellant, just jumping, but it would have been a little difficult. It would have been a little difficult, so. Oh, hang on a second. Also, I need to turn that off, this off. And yep. Here we go. Where is the station here? Okay, we're actually behind it. And what I did last time, I kind of just kind of launched right when it was passing. It seemed to work well, and I'm going to go ahead and try that again. I think I might just kind of launch it right when it passes. And we should be good to go. Okay, we're going to give it just a couple minutes here, because what I need to do now is also reconfigure the landing engines. I did kind of change the balance of these things. Let's go ahead and take a look at this. 74 is what I did. These are at full thrust. Now I believe these need to be about 85. So having this module like that definitely changed the center of mass. 85, I think, is what we wanted it at. We'll go ahead and target our station. Set this target. It is just above the horizon here, approaching. Why no on-screen chat today? I don't do it for KSPTV. I don't know if it's against the rules or not, but I know how they are kind of strict about that sort of thing. I just don't bother. Okay, so let's just do... Maybe if we can go and get make sure this thing is out of the way first. And let's go ahead and roll over. You see, even though I have all these reaction wheels, this thing is so sluggish to turn. That kind of makes me a little unhappy. The last one of these I built actually wasn't that bad to control. We're just trying to get it out of the way here. We've got plenty of fuel to play. Do we have TAC fuel balancer on still? Yes, we do. Yes, we do. That is great. The way that this vessel is designed is a little cheaper in construction, so we had to use electronics in order to manage the fuel balancing. Electronics being TAC fuel balancer. So, yep, here we go. Alright, and we've landed again. We're just waiting for this thing to get a little bit closer, and we'll go ahead and pass. We'll go ahead and get on going here. So what? Okay, 18 kilometers. I think that's pretty much what we want to do. So what we're going to do is just kind of start going up here. Go. We can raise the landing gear too. We can go ahead and turn off those engines and then turn on the main engines here in just a moment. This thing will stabilize. There we go. Alright, nice flying chronic fender. You finally got your finger unstuck. You You're looking like you're doing pretty well here. Looking cool, looking cool. I don't know if we did this at the right timing, but we're gonna see how we do it here. It might take us a little bit to get this perfect, but yeah. Let's set it to orbit mode right now. Are the dev notes out yet? I guess they're not. They're usually out by the time I stream. Well, then again, I'm kind of streaming earlier relative to everybody else in the universe, so. Alright, how are we doing? We are definitely making our way to orbital velocity. Looks like we are going to be a little bit behind our target. Of course, we are a little bit south, too. A little bit underneath, but I think we're doing okay. I think we're doing just fine. Just go ahead and burn down below the horizon here. I think we'll be okay. Our eccentricity is going down. As soon as that gets close to zero, that means we're almost going to be in orbit. Let's go ahead and... burning down like this. We'll see our periapsis is now raising. It's about 19 kilometers away from the station. Okay. Oh, shoot. You see how we're actually, our apoapsis is now actually pretty darn high. I'm gonna need to fix that by actually burning radial in. It's, you know, it's inefficient, but we do have plenty of fuel to play with. We got a place with fuel down there, and eventually we'll be dropping fuel pods and then bring them back up to the station for refueling. You know, we're not gonna have any problem in that regard. So, what's going on here? Also, stop rotating, you jerk. Alright. So, now we got something here. We have a... Oh, we actually have a pretty close encounter. 8.9? That's not as close as the last one. But as we can see here, this is actually close to 5.8. We might be able to even adjust that even more if we adjust the timing a little bit. Maybe if we... So this is the intersect, and that's where we need to be. So if we get there later... So burning in maybe might fix that. Yes, it will. All right, looking good. Looking very good. This is just kind of a... This just kind of happens by accident. I really don't know what I'm doing here. It just kind of... When I get back in orbit, it's definitely going to be giving me some... Yeah, see, that's actually a problem. And actually, we're going to be lower. But as we approach, we can actually burn higher into it. So, yeah. 3.4, close, no cigar, but I think we'll be okay. Let's see here. Periapsis will be 4 kilometers, though. Will that be an issue? That may be an issue. We'll go ahead and keep our eye on it, but I think we'll be okay. Because if I remember, the lowest point in the orbit is, what, like 4 something? Like, probably be about what this periapsis is, but I think we're okay. And as, of course, we are raising back in orbit again. And there's our target getting a little bit closer. As we approach it, we'll go ahead and maybe point up now. Let's set the target velocity. Uh-oh. There's the aliens again! Wow! You can see them from far away. What are with these aliens, man? Huh. I don't know what we did, but the space station is shooting lasers or something. I really want to know what that phenomena is from. Weird happenings. Really weird happenings. Shimmy Das JJ. I see what you did there. There's another alien. What in the world? I don't know what I did. Yeah, 700 meters in the ground. That's nothing. We're fine. We're fine. Yeah. Yeah. Yes, I do use OBS. I do use OBS. All right. We are now approaching the station. Should be within 200 meters. So we're looking great. There's some thing on the wing. I can't do a Kirk impression that well, but speaking of Kirk, Star Trek, great series. All right, we'll go ahead and keep an eye out for more aliens. More aliens. Just shooting out just from that station. I don't know what's going on there. If anybody is familiar, yeah, there's another one. It's this is Dane's fault. Dane, have you developed photon torpedo technology? Another one. It seems like they pop out at regular intervals. That is really weird. Alright. So what I'm trying to do is just kind of point myself kind of towards the retro vector here so we can slow down and kind of guide ourselves as we approach the station. Hello, Kirkerman. How's it going? We were just talking about you, kind of. Not really. Maybe. Alright, how far are we out? We are 3.9 kilometers out. Make sure that we avoid whatever the photon torpedoes or whatever is being shot out here. See? See? Just at regular intervals. Maybe they're packs of information. I do have distant object enhancement. I'm pretty sure it's a glitch related to that, but it's just weird that they just keep shooting out like that every now and then. Maybe it's the... Let's go and turn this off. See, shouldn't that actually be creating a point of light representing the station? I'll go ahead and just... And it isn't. Maybe my distant object enhancement is just completely borked. Hmm. approaching the station here. That it's a moon. That's no moon. Okay, 2.9. We're approaching 2.8. Looks like they're getting a little bit more dim. I don't know if that has to do with the angle. 2.7. 2.6. We will be in loading range here any moment. Go ahead and dock this thing back up to the space station, and then we'll go ahead and work on returning the tug back to Kerbin orbit. Now the thing is, we're probably going to want to go ahead and fix that wibble wobble right now, so actually before we return it back, we'll go ahead and take all those struts that we attached, and we'll bring that. Yeah, we'll go ahead and take all those struts, attach them to the tug, and then we will take it back to the Kerbin orbit. Station is loading. Game just kind of froze for just a moment here. Dev notes aren't out yet. Curse you. Alright, we are now approaching. Go ahead and time warp. I think it's because I went, like, 100x time warp is... what I had the problem. Let's not do that again. Let's get within 500 kilometers. We'll go ahead and clean this up and get a little bit closer. Hey, Jimmy, you want to take your CCNA2 final exam? That's Cisco, right? That's Cisco Networking Essentials? No, I don't want to take that. I absolutely do not want to take that. I'm sorry. Something about OSI layer and... routers. Jimmy, can that lander land crew as well, or we need to plant a land, a crew lander? Yeah, I'm probably going to be designing a reusable crew lander too, so we're going to need to design one of those eventually. Basically a lander that's just designed to be refueled. I might just go ahead and just take a Betelgeuse lander and just take it out here and just keep reusing it. Actually, we may have a Betelgeuse lander out here orbiting. And we could dock it up. We could tug it over here and dock it up with the station. And we could just use that, honestly. It only takes two crew, though. So actually, that might be a bad idea. I might want to build something a little bit bigger that can take quite a bit... quite a few crew. Maybe design something kind of based on the Freya module. I don't know. We'll see. But I also could like create like a module that goes in here designed to carry crew, but that'd be a little bit too complicated. I'd prefer not to do that. So we are just barely passing here. Said I wanted to dock to this docking port right here, and I'm kind of rubbing vigorously. Okay. All right, activate RCS. Do we have any? Yes, we do. Thank you. Relative velocity, 4.4. Why are you calling me Edward? Oh, wait, what is the streamer's name? Oh, somebody named Edward was asking me who I was. Yep, I'm Shimmy the JJ. This is a multi-stream channel, so we do have multiple different streamers that do stream to this channel. This is the official channel for Kerbal Space Program, commissioned by Squad, the developer for Kerbal Space Program. I do stream on my own channel multiple times a week, though, if somebody might want to link my information in chat here in a moment. You can go ahead and follow me there. It's Shimmy the JJ. Twitch, whatever. So, yeah. Anyway. Yep, IPR's got the schedule there. We got all sorts of different streamers. And then somebody might link my channel there. Anyway, we're going to go ahead and dock up to that docking port. We're a little far off. A little bit farther off than I wanted to be, but not too bad, not too bad. And honestly, we could dock on this port too if we wanted. We just want to dock in the different direction. I'd rotate it by 90 degrees. But I think just to keep everything stable, I'm going to want to dock to this one. So, let's... Yeah. You're wearing your Christmas hat. I don't have a Christmas hat. I'm kind of sad. I've seen other streamers wear various festive hats, and I do not have one. I'm kind of a bah humbug when it comes to Christmas and stuff like that. I might want to get something, though. Also, thank you, IPR. Yeah, no, my first name is not Edward. That guy's name is Edward.
Broadcasting.
And also, thank you for the follow on my channel, Edward State Alchemist. I do appreciate it. And if you haven't already, consider following Kerbal Space Program TV, KSP TV, where I'm at right now. Woo-hoo. That was my Vanna White something. I'd like to buy a vowel. Okay. Let's set this as target here. And control from here. Now we're gonna use RCS for the rest of this. Also, are we going in the right direction? We're going in that direction. We wanna be kind of getting closer to where we wanna go. That was a nothing statement if I've ever heard one. So let's go ahead and use RCS to adjust my trajectory here. And actually thinking about it, we might want to avoid this docking port just specifically because it's close to the solar panels. And if I don't have to dock to it, I won't. So I think I'll go ahead and dock to this one. You want a Christmas hug? I'll give you a Christmas hug. That can be arranged. I don't think that actually can be arranged. I'm sorry. If there was a situation where somebody asked me for a Christmas hug, I would give you a Christmas hug. All right, let's go ahead. Control from here. There we go. And now we will go ahead and rotate our owls around towards the orientation of our docking port. So thanks for following NV_FC. Welcome to the quest, as I say on my channel. It's the Shimmy's Space Quest. Did I select the white right one? No, I didn't. Oh, dagnabbit. Okay. Here we go. Let me get this thing rotated around. Rather sluggish. Vessel. Now, this may be the last stream. Dude! Captain JRT! Dude, you are too nice, man. $5. Happy streaming. Really appreciate that. Thank you very much. Every bit helps. I know you've donated several times before, but thank you again. Thank you very much. That makes my day. Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. It's not girl, it's girl. It's my buddy Nick. It's kind of his catchphrase. What he says all the time. And I had him record that for me. Give a little reverb and processing. Why is this a family-friendly stream when Shimi is constantly brutally murdering Kerbals? I don't know about you, but when is the last time I murdered a Kerbal? I know everybody will actually remember when the Kerbals were murdered. It was a little while ago. I'm not constantly. Your catchphrase is eat your corn. Okay. That's good advice, I suppose. We tempted fate. Oh, wait. Oh, that's... Sorry. I'm replying to somebody in somebody else's chat. Never mind. Alright. I think we are now kind of going in the right direction here. I think all we need to do is just do a little time warpy-do, and then... Just gonna go ahead and come on home. So here we go. A little time warpy-do. Okay. Bring it back to one. Go ahead and bring this in. Bring our vector in here. Yeah, we did kind of brutally injure Midanthrope. Poor Midanthrope. Ever since then, he's never been back. Well, now he has. He's just been away on personal family. I don't know what he's off somewhere. Work, family, vacation. He's somewhere. Not here though. Wibbly wobble. Yeah, it was the Kerbal's fault for wearing the Habba's hat. Yeah, the only two Kerbals I actually really killed were No Io and Shaper. And I've since then renamed... Oh, well, I haven't renamed, but I've named bases after them. Zogs was declared dead, but we went ahead and found him alive. And we returned him back home in secret. On stream isn't much of a secret, but the Kerbal public is not privy to this knowledge. Should be back within a week. Yeah, yeah. I can't remember. Is he gonna miss EFT1? I hope he doesn't. EFT1, the Delta IV heavy launch of the Orion spacecraft on Thursday morning, debuting the first flight of the Orion spacecraft. That should be really exciting. Should be testing its various systems and the heat shield. That's pretty cool. Alright, let's go ahead and time warp in a little bit more. Oh wow, I didn't realize how close we were. Let's be a little careful here. Okay. So, relative velocity... 10 meters a second, or 10 meters a second, 10 centimeters a second. This thing does wobble a bit. Moral of the story, time's not a ball. What? And hello, John Casual, how's it going? Yep, EFT, only in 2 days, EFT1. Okay. Let's... Oh, that's the wrong direction. We are close. This thing will kind of... magnetize in a bit, but we want to get this thing close at least. Come on. Come on. Get this thing close. So we can see there. Go ahead and zoom on in. Here we go. How are we doing? I think we got magnetization. Yeah, I think it's locking it in. Let's go ahead and slow down our... and docked! Wow, that worked out really well. Looking great. This station does appear to be just some sort of hodgepodge, though. Don't like exactly how it turned out, but you know what? Whatever. I think we're good. Time is a ball. People assume that time is a strict progression from cause to effect. In reality, from a non-linear subjective viewpoint, it is more like another direction or two of that duration. A big wibbly-wobbly timey-wimey line of space. Oh, is that a direct quote of Doctor Who? Or are you just making something up? Alrighty, so Chronic Offender, you have another mission to do here. We are going to need you to add some structural stability to the tug here, hopefully. So that should be fun. Let's go ahead and get you out. More EVA. Even slower than before. Hey, thanks, Gav. When do they launch, Orion? On Thursday, like 7 a.m. Eastern time, so pretty early in the morning for me. I can't decide whether or not I want to wake up early or go to bed late. Let's just go ahead and grab this. So I'm going to go ahead and try and attach all these. It's going to be a little weird. A little weird. How are we going to do this? Maybe we can only... oh yeah, we're only going to use 4, because I only brought 8. So maybe I can attach them to the RCS? Yes, I can. Okay, looking great. So I can go ahead and put 1 here. It's going to be really interesting. Isn't point... yeah, sorry, it's 10 centimeters a second, is what I meant to say. I was getting all confused. I'm sorry. How is his jetpack fuel? What? You could TiVo it and sleep in it. No, I gotta watch it live. That's part of the thing. These things you have to watch live. It is incredibly exciting. It's like when I watched the Antares launch live, and then unfortunately it blew up. That was an experience I never thought I'd ever experience in my lifetime, watching just something like that just completely blow up. You know, luckily nobody was hurt, of course, but that was just like, you know. People like to say, like watching a train wreck, and in a way it kind of is, but, you know, it's unmanned. So, nobody was hurt, just... it's just unfortunate. Yeah. The announcer guy definitely seemed a little stressed when he was telling everybody to do what they needed to do. I don't blame him. Go ahead and grab this last one. Yep, the lag is real. I will be upgrading my computer later today. Oh, got some things in the way there. But, you know, I was really considering going, I might just want to cancel my KSP TV stream, because I want to put together my computer. But, you know what, I just said, you know, the show must go on. We'll go ahead and do what we need to do, and then go ahead and put the computer together. So we got all four of those. We're going to go ahead and bring a couple more around, make sure that we can actually connect. Go ahead and link them all together. While we are at it, let's F5 for safety. Let's go ahead and grab this. Later, Skull Gaming. You probably won't see me there because I am streaming. But thanks for saying bye. Attach here. Can we rotate? It's like B and B, right? Oh, B and N. Oops. No. Set that to auto. Okay. So here's what we're gonna do. Let me go ahead and link these together to improve structural stability. I don't know if that's really gonna work. I think it will, though. If we can, that'd be great. Do you think people would be interested in you streaming some old PC, new PC comparisons? I don't know. Alright. Let's go ahead and get this. Go ahead and attach you do here. Go ahead and link. There we go. Need to do this just two more times, and I think we should be good. What new parts did I get? A new MOBO processor. I got a new PSU. RAM. So basically a new computer. I pretty much got a new computer. New case, too. Things I will be carrying over from my other computer are various hard drives and video card. Alright, let's go ahead and open the dev notes here. I'm actually rather interested in seeing that. So, if you wouldn't mind me checking here after go ahead and link this together, I want to go ahead and take a look at those dev notes. Alright. Let's go on and hang out here for just a moment. Let's see what we got. Talk about bug fixing. Working really hard. Alright. Issues and things. Okay. Alright. P- pilots. Okay. So, I remember seeing a tweet by Max Maps something about pilot skills. Basically, pilot skills are a set of additional SAS type modes, which allow the pilot to lock onto various vectors. All of these modes are available in Sandbox, but they will only activate in Career as you level up Kerbals with a pilot trait. Okay, so they're basically the like the smart ASS or the flight computer in Remote Tech. I'm assuming that's something kind of like that. That's pretty cool. Let's see here. Implementing building rec models. QA stuff. Okay, more of that. Push. All right. All right, let's go ahead and take a look at this picture. Ooh, stability assist, maneuver, prograde, retrograde, normal, anti-normal rate. Oh, target, anti-target. Ooh, cool. All right, that's pretty neat. That's pretty neat. Ooh, there's mod called antenna range. I might want to look at that. I've been looking for possible art alternatives to Remote Tech. Okay, all right. I was hoping that we'd see some cargo bay pictures, but it looks like we did not get to see those. But yeah, all right. So they're pretty much adding the smart ASS module into the game. In various ways, basically, crew can and do that for you, as you can level them up. Pretty neat. Neato Frito. Okay, where did I put the struts here? I think the last one is there. Yes, it is. There we go. Yeah, hold on, normal and anti-normal are really going to be useful for Burns. I completely agree. Alright, so the last one is going to be in here. It's going to be maybe a little careful. Let's not go ahead and break into the solar panels while we kind of scooch ourselves in here. Whoa! Hitting the wrong key. Careful, buddy. You almost ruined everything. That. Here we go. Added a little extra structural stability to the tug. We might have been able to add more, but we'll just go ahead and leave it at that. Let's go ahead and put you back into the station, and then we will be good to go. We'll go ahead and continue on with the mission. We'll be bringing the tug back down to low Kerbin orbit to prepare to bring up another... Also, did I hit something? Why can't I... Link mode enabled? No. Why can't I rotate? Okay, I was like, did the camera change? Is that what happened? I couldn't, like, control the... What is going on here? This camera's changing. What it... Oh, I see what's happening. Okay. Basically what's going on is because I was using the RCS, and since I'm so close to... Since I'm so close to deorbiting, just him kind of drifting off in one direction caused him to go be suborbital. And because of that, the camera was automatically changing because I had him in auto mode. That makes sense. Okay. I was like, why is he changing all over the place? Yep. Alright, I really thought something really weird was going on with the game. So now that I'm in dedicated free mode here, I think we should be fine. It shows how little it would deorbit the station. Actually, putting this thing so low might have been a bad idea, honestly. But you know, whatever. Alrighty, so that is taken care of. I think we should plan on returning the tug back into low curve orbit, and then we'll go ahead and see if we can design a service module for the base. It's probably be a little bit more massive than the base already is. So we might need to send up more fuel to Shaper. Anyway, let's go and undock. There's RCS to kind of back away a little bit. Why is the station so low? Oh, because people told me to. That's pretty much why. I was like, oh, how low should I put this? And everyone's like, you should put it 6 kilometers. So I was like, no, that's a little bit too low. And so we kind of stuck with somewhere in between 8 and 9. So that's how that happened. Oops. No, let's go back. We need to rename this thing. What did I designate the last probe, the last tug as? Let's go ahead and take a look at my mission list here. I don't really remember. Kind of put it together rapidly. I think it was a Polaris. Okay, scroll down. Tug deployment. Orbital payload tug. I don't think I ever named it. Orbital payload tug. I think I was going to call it the Polaris. Yeah, whatever. Go and name it the Polaris. Finally balance my orbit so I can orbit at 500 meters. Yeah, right. That'd be ridiculous. Alright, so what are we doing? We are renaming this guy here. Rename vessel. Rename it. To... Is it a ship? It's a ship. Not a probe. But it's... Yeah, it's a probe. Here we go. Yep, I showed IPR beforehand. I'm sorry. IPR cheats. This is actually pretty darn close to what we want. Let's go ahead and give it a little bit more. Also, we're going to need to give it some downward motion here so we can reduce the amount of relative inclination to the equator here. Yeah, just like that. That looks good. I think now we're just barely... No, we're not colliding. Let's go ahead and set the moon as our target, so that will tell us our relative inclination for this orbit, I believe. Let's see, it says 2 degrees or so. Can I pop up the node again? Nope. Let's see. Descending. Let's slow it down a little bit more. Nope. Looks like that. Looks like moon isn't going to troll us. That is great. Curve periapsis is a little high, though. It's going to bring that down a little bit more. What are we at? 2 million meters? Yeah, 2 million. A little bit more. 500. Up just a little bit more. There we go. 300. Alright. Alright, we'll go ahead and leave it at that. We'll go ahead and clean it up here in the future. If we pull that up, we'll be relative 2.1 degrees. Looking good. Also, hello, Revila. I know you said hello to me earlier. I didn't actually reply to you. Sorry about that. Nalaya said earlier, we appreciate the dedication to the show, but if it was me, the smell of all those extra polygons in a box right next to me would drive me bonkers. Yeah, I know. Yep. Kind of anxious to work on that, but you know what? It is what it is. We're just going to go ahead and keep on playing here. And take care of that later. So maybe tomorrow on my channel, we'll get a quicker, more responsive Shimmy Space Quest. Things will not be as slow and lethargic, but who knows? You never know. It is Kerbal Space Program. It does need a little work. And I have it modded heavily, so that's an issue too. So anyway, we will now just go ahead and wait for our orbit to come around here. How long does it say that we're going to need to do this burn? Something like a couple minutes, probably. Great. And it always ends up where I'm, like, pointed right at the station. But luckily, we need to actually add some downward velocity, so that's good. So if we go ahead and just give it a little love tap. 1 minute, so about 30 seconds. Let's go ahead and double-check Kerbal Engineer. It says time to node burn in about 5 minutes. So, yeah, we're looking good. Let's go ahead and switch over to Chase. As you can see, as soon as that station went out of range, the game's a little bit more punchier, isn't it? A little bit more responsive. There we go. So now it says I have 5,000 meters per second delta V. Interesting. Looks like I might pass back into the loading range of the station as I pass by it. Who knows, though? We'll see. Is that base? What is that? What are we looking at? That is one of our landing sites, but that is not the base. Okay. Doobie-doo. 13 seconds and counting down. T-minus 11 seconds. Five, four, three, two, one. and burn. There we go. Station, yeah, we're probably gonna pass back into loading range, so we'll go a little slow here for a few minutes. Or maybe a couple. Maybe a minute. Maybe 30 seconds. I don't know. 2.8, 2.7, 2.6, 2.5, 2.4, 2.3. It's loading. Loading. How full throttle up? The Z key. Hit that Z key, it immediately throttles up. Amazing extra little feature. Yep, and X is throttled down. Z has just only been in there since the last update. X has been in there for quite a while. Or Z, for those of you with a non-American keyboard, and you have Z keys instead of Z keys, you can have the Z key instead. All right, there goes the station. If we go ahead and turn this off. Just barely see it, just passing it by. It's kind of cool. It's just a little speck on the screen. Is that home? Nope. That's the same. That's the flag. That's the same flag I was looking at earlier. It's not home. Alright, and here in just any moment, it's gonna get faster again. And unloaded. Well, there we go. Nice. Very nice. Second left. By the way, while we're at it, let's go and extend these panels. Alright, how we doing? We are now heading on out. Looks like we won't need to worry about the moon. We do have a slight inclination that we'll need to fix eventually. With 156, we could go ahead and just fix it down there. Yeah. Alright. Let's go to F5 for safety and then go ahead and warp on out. Oops. Well, it wasn't very accurate anyway. Alright, whatever. We weren't going for precision re-entry trajectory at that point anyway, so we're fine. We're fine. I think, hopefully. Mm. Finally got this game! Congratulations! It's one of the best games ever created in all time. Of all time. So, I don't know what I actually should be air braking at. Like 50 something? We went through this last time, and I was really confused. So here, I'm just going to go ahead and burn. If this thing would unstabilize there. Or restabilize. Burn and just kind of use trajectories like before. I think around 50-something, 60. It's around 60, I think, is where what it was telling us last time. Let's see here. Let's go ahead and turn on trajectories. Let's see what it tells us. Okay. If we now go ahead and activate, not decouple, inflate heat shield. Let's go ahead and inflate the heat shield. And then tell trajectories to give us something at a negative angle here. Okay, it's going to give us slightly different, but obviously we can see there, we should pass through the atmosphere relatively unharmed. Oh, wait, now it just updated. Oh, well, then that happened. Have I ever come close to another collision with another spacecraft? Yep, all the time. Because I like to live dangerously, I guess. Okay. Oops. Kerbin. So I could burn a little bit more in, because we know that this pretty much takes us down to something like here. You know, something like here, something like that. But we still need to do the plane change maneuver, so I'll go ahead and worry about that in a little bit. So we will just go ahead and time warp a little bit. Go ahead and do a plane change, about 2 degrees. It's gonna be quite a bit of a plane change, but it's necessary in order to be realigned with the space station that we'll be docking at. What are we at? Latitude, longitude is now dropping. Go ahead and time warp down. Descending node, we'll go ahead and point northish. Still 2 degrees of inclination. I really should have just kind of made it so I changed it up here. Yeah, trying to make, sometimes trying to make it as good as possible, but not exactly, might be a bad idea. I should have just kind of slightly adjusted it so my node was up here and I could have changed it at just a few meters a second. So I kind of made a mistake there. So descending node. The crap? Oh. That was a thing I shouldn't have done. Let's go ahead and try that again. Let's try that burn take two without trying to burn our heat shield off. 3, 2, 1, go. Here we go. It's like, Why is it not working, and why are we getting a burning sound? All right. Alright, less than 1 degree relative. Alright, looking good. Go ahead and change that up there if we needed. But we're relative inclination to the equator. 0 degrees. Now we need to go ahead and just kind of clean up this re-entry though. We kind of slightly brought it up a little bit. I think I might want to bring this down a little bit more. Yes. Yes. So see if we go ahead and bring this down. See, it actually significantly adjusts, so I don't want to bring this down too far. Maybe 59.5. See, that actually might bring us down a little bit. You know what? Let's go and try it. 59.5. We are just over halfway in between the distance between the surface and my satellite network there, geostationary. What is that? That's Eve. Okay. And now we'll go ahead and inflate the heat shield again. Hey, Brewclaw, how's it going? Is it really nice up there? Nice and chilly up in Prescott? That seems like a really nice place to be right now. Nice and chilly, enjoyable. Where's the planet? Almost lost the planet. We're going this direction. Alrighty, let's go ahead and tell this to be surface grade minus. Pretty much what I'm using right here is just what we've confirmed that will be added to a later version of Kerbal Space Program, but with Kerbals. I don't think it'll be a probe thing yet. Maybe it will be probes. I don't know. It's hard to say. And now we're going to go ahead and tell the computer to... In 10 minutes. 10 minutes is 600 seconds. We'll go ahead and target Kerbin. And... yeah, that's already active. And then activate that. And then this will activate... and then we need it. Okay, crap. Set this to. Well, that's back to zero again. Zero. And we'll go ahead and retract this now. And retract this now. Please. Deactivate it. Oh, no. No, I goofed. I did it in the wrong order. We might lose a dish. What is outside? I do not know. So yeah, it is very possible that we might break this comms dish. I don't know yet. I really don't know. But luckily we have a backup. We could always bring another one to attach to it too. So we want a couple. Just retract. I can't retract the dish. It's this thing called remote tech, and this is how it works. I don't know if you can see right here, but it says no connection to send command on. Well, there goes your DirecTV. Considering that it hasn't broken off yet, that's a good sign. But we will be... climbing out of the atmosphere here, hopefully. I really hope. It's taken a while, though. It really doesn't want to. Okay, actually, now we're getting to the thick of it. Now we're getting to the thick of it. Yep. We still have this dish. Is it burning? We are not burning the dish. The dish is fine. We might get a little charcoal or a little charred on the edge there, but it should still work. Thanks, Ipeer. Appreciate that. Currently at how many G's? 1.5 and rising. The reason why I can't retract is because remote tech is not allowing me to. Currently, this vehicle is currently under its own control. It is not communicating with the network, so we can't tell it to do commands on it. We can't have it do commands or anything like that. We can't tell it to do things. I pretty much told it to hold this kind of position as it re-entered, and in 10 minutes everything's going to go ahead and reactivate, and then we'll go have control again. One thing I'm worried about, though, I forgot to tell it to reactivate the panels too, like before. Alrighty, just at periapsis here. You can see that the projected orbit is lowering. We gotta be worried about that. We still have the dish. We are right at periapsis, so I don't think... if it doesn't break here in the next 5 seconds, we'll be fine. Actually, no. It's not going to break, because our G-force is now lowering, so we should be fine. It's not going to land, it's just going to air brake. This is a vehicle that I want to keep reusing continually. Okay, alright. Raising the orbit again. Why would you reuse the thing? It sacks. I don't know. I'll get it one of these days. All right, we're still 1.5 G's here with a peak of 1.85. It is lowering, so I think about the halfway mark was a good recommendation. It's definitely gonna go lower than it predicted. Loving all the rain right now, although any colder than that you would probably be watching. Yeah, it wanted a sprinkle earlier today, but I don't think it did. So good thing to know, this does work. Through the re-entry process. Through the air brake process. Not so bad. Not so bad. See, it's now dropping it lower and lower. That's a bit of an issue. But just so long as it doesn't drop so low that I can't get out of the atmosphere without, well, yeah, if I can't get out of the atmosphere, you know. You're fine. Though. Let us see. Currently 1G here. I'm gonna do something low. Pull up my memory usage. That hollow says science. I completely agree. Whatever you're replying to there. How we at right now? Still significant G-force. I don't want to fizz warp while we're under significant G-force because that could significantly affect our air brake process. It will be less accurate. I don't want to mess around with that. So once it gets down to like 1% of a G, then I'll go ahead and fizz warp it, and we'll go ahead and get this to go out faster. Yeah, we got a lot of rain this year. Well, this monsoon season. We don't get a lot of rain all year round, but we get a point in which it rains a lot. And then it's back to dry again, so... Alright, how we doing? We are at 1/3 of a G and falling. Let's see our predicted orbit. It is low. Yeah, alrighty. I think this is about as low as I want to go, because any lower, I think it exponentially just drops, and then you just won't ever exit the atmosphere. And that's a bad thing. I want to keep reusing the thing. Even though it sacks. Who would like KSP on a phone or mobile version? Isn't there a game already on one that's kind of inspired by KSP called Simple Rockets, I believe? And Saibu Tank! It's a new person! Saibu Tech and Random Tank have merged into one person. You are now Saibu Tank!
Their powers combined. I am Saibu Tank.
I'm out of it today. I guess I didn't sleep well. I had a dream earlier this morning, that I was in class We were learning about, I don't know, space, or it might have been about, maybe it was about biology. I really can't remember. But all I remember is later, everybody died. I have some of the weirdest dreams. And I was trying to escape the psychopath serial killer person. So, yeah, that's always good. That's always good. Then I woke up. It's pretty much why I didn't sleep that well. Kind of a bit of a bad dream. Yeah. Say, oh my. Oh my. I had a dream, yes, more like a nightmare. Well, not really. It wasn't really emotional for me. But, yeah. So as we are about 4% of a G. Let's just go ahead and give it a 4x fizz warp here. And we'll go ahead and climb out of the atmosphere ASAP. And then we'll go ahead and get ready to rendezvous with the station. And people are sending me messages on Steam, so I gotta go ahead and exit Steam, unfortunately. Keep talking, Dr. Andy is there. What? Is that person even here? Yeah, you know who you are. People having to hit busy on all my different chat programs. It's such a hassle. Alright, so now we need to go ahead and select Shaper Lab as a target. And when we... Wait, we're not under acceleration. We are not under acceleration. You jerk face. Also, oh, are we reconnected? Okay, we are reconnected. Yes. Let's go ahead and disable this. Deactivate and extend the panels. It'd be a shame if someone were mentioned tacos or something. I could go for tacos, but I had plenty to eat today. Maybe I had too much junk food today, I don't know. Maybe that's why I feel tired. So let's turn off trajectories. We don't need you anymore. What we'll now do is bring our... We need to actually do a slight adjustment there. I'll go and bring our periapsis roughly the same altitude as the Shaper Lab. Also, stop doing what you're doing there. Also, why are you spinning like crazy? Let's go ahead and deflate the heat shield. Toggle, just like that. There we go. 256 by 261. Oh, wow. Station got bumped a little bit. Wasn't intended, but slightly off now. Might need to fix that in the future. Oh, actually, it's 250, not 150. All right, let's keep burning. The closer that these things get together, means the closer I am getting this to the right periapsis for that point in the orbit. Okay, just like that. I think that's good. Now we'll go ahead and do a slight orbital plane adjustment here at the descending node. What I should have done is actually targeted the space station and not the... and not the equatorial plane. Oh well, that's no problem. talking about space hot pockets. What? What do we have to say? Happy Triangle. Happy Triangle. Oops. That's fine. And now we'll go ahead and plan a burn here close to the periapsis. It's about right here. This is my favorite part of rendezvousing, coming in from a higher orbit, is watching this thing spin around a bit. So I think only one spin is probably what we're going to do. Two spins is probably going to be too much. Yeah. So we'll go ahead and bring this back out. Fortunately, we're going to have a bit of a relative velocity as we approach maybe 600 or more. We'll go ahead and we'll go for this intercept. That is off by 7 kilometers. We'll go ahead and bring it in. It's a little bit more. 1.6. Great. Perfect. We are 46 minutes from the burn. Is that our target? Maybe. Random tank is trying to is plotting against me, evidently. In Australia, they're called pizza pockets, are they? Or is that a lie? Everybody remember the commercial from for Bagel Bites? You remember? Pizza in the morning, pizza in the evening, pizza at supper time. When pizza's on a bagel, you can eat pizza anytime. Remember that? No. I do. And that's kind of how it went, I think. And also, hello, Will Glasson. How's it going? Yeah, I love Bagel Bites. That was pretty much what I survived on when I was younger, when I was a teenager. When I was a wee lad. Even though I'm still a bit of a wee lad, but when I was a weer lad. You can eat pizza anytime anyway. No, you can't. No, you can't. You can only eat pizza anytime when it is on a bagel. Because that's what the commercials told me. But growing up, I also had like, it was like a hot pocket, but it was like a breakfast thing. So it had egg and sausage and bacon and cheese and that sort of thing. Does anybody remember that? I forget what those were called. Maybe they're just breakfast hot pockets. They were more pastry-like. I used to eat those all the time until I kind of got sick of them. All right, we are 14 seconds from burn. This will be the first burn for rendezvous towards Shaper Station. What we do is slow ourselves down significantly so we phase up properly with the station, and then we go ahead and do it again. 3, 2, 1. Anyone remember the Sunny D commercial with the purple stuff? Yeah, that was a Dave Chappelle joke, wasn't it? Wasn't it Dave Chappelle? Maybe, I don't know. But I remember that. Hello, Delta V's. How is it going today? Sorry, I'm a little bit out of it today. Just feel tired, unfortunately. I don't know why. I spent time outside today, and I think the outside just drained my life force. It's also possibly I didn't get enough sleep, or the fact that my life force is being drained by my new computer parts. They're just kind of sitting over there across the way in my room. It could be many different things, but right now, a little out of it. So, I'm dealing with it. Now we'll go ahead and use our CS to go ahead and clean ourselves up here. Let's see, 1 point something, 1.2, 1.41, no, 1.2, there we go. 20 minutes till JAXA launch. They're launching the Hayabusa, right? I'm not too familiar with that mission, but I guess they're doing another something to a moon or a probe or something, I don't know. Moon or a probe? No, moon or an asteroid? Maybe a, thing? No, outside is a vampire. Maybe I met a vampire outside. That is very possible, and I didn't know. Did I sparkle in the twilight? Yes, I did. I was fabulous. I have two red dots in my neck, probably. Probably just blemishes. Surface sample return from asteroid. Okay. It is... They must have installed that mod that allows you to take surface samples from probes. I think they installed that mod. If I am correct. Pizza in the morning, pizza in the evening, pizza at supper time. When pizza on a bagel. So this burn is gonna take 1 minute, 38 seconds? Holy crap. Might be an issue. We need to make sure we burn early. You caught me, Xer. You caught me. All right. So doing the burn here might be a little weird. Yes. Target relative velocity is 700. Oh boy. Oh dear. Oh my word. So I'm gonna go ahead and just kind of go with what an engineer says, but I'm gonna go ahead and start the burn a second early, I think. Just so I know. I won't be overshooting it. I'd rather undershoot it than overshoot it. Hello, Mijan, how's it going? Brune, random tank says. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, burn. Also, I'm going to be doing it like this. What's the mission tonight? Well, I've just been kind of doing a little cleanup. I went ahead and finished the mission from Sunday night, where I landed a base module on the surface of Minmus. I went ahead and completed that, brought the LLV back up to Shaper, or not Shaper, No IO Depot, and then I'm bringing the tug back to Shaper Lab. So that's what I'm working on right now. After this, assuming that we can get this in place, where are we at, 18? Assuming we can get this in place, then we will start working on designing the service module to attach to the station, to the base, Zog's lab, Zog's mine, lab, mine, depot, whatever the crap it is. It's a thing, it's a place. Relative velocity 300. Okay. .250 at 8.5 and falling. .6 falling. I can bring this down to 50, I'll be happy. And then once I get into loading, I can go ahead and bring it down even lower. Engine cut. All right, so we'll just go ahead and drift towards the station at roughly 50 meters a second. Yeah, we're almost here. We are almost here. Are those just nuclear engines? Yes, they are just nuclear engines. Four of them, kind of in this cloverleaf kind of configuration. We've got some fuel tank here and some fuel tank behind there. All sorts of fuel tank all over the place. You're waiting for an unscheduled separation event. Shh, don't say such things. It's inappropriate. Alright. I'm out of water. I need to get more water. That's why she drinks from the red cup. He drinks the color red. Oh, I see what you did there. Somebody wanted me to say Hot Pockets in a sexy voice.
Hot Pockets. Hot Pockets. John Madden. Hot Pockets. Cheese. Cheese pizza. I would like to order a pizza, please. No. Why? Because you are John Madden.
Yeah, not 50 kilometers a second yet. It's not anything because there's nothing inside. See? Like some John Madden Hot Pockets. I don't know what that's supposed to mean, but it sounds a little sketch right there. All right, we are 1.7 kilometers out. Let's go ahead and bring our relative velocity to 30. Okay, we kind of overdid the thinger right there. Let's go ahead and bring it down again. There we go. Alright. Both KSP TV and EG are constant buffering. I know that I'm not dropping any frames, so it's either Twitch or it's your internet. The cup is empty! Mine! Bro! And I'm really thirsty, though. I drank all the water. Sounds like Stephen Hawking with a sore throat. Okay. It probably sounds like Stephen Hawking with a regular throat, too. I don't think the soreness of his throat really matters. Can't find glass Coca-Colas anywhere. Costco has them. I bought some more today. We're just 1 kilometer out. At the frames, man. Look at this. 8 frames a minute. There we go. No, Shimmy, it's Wednesday. It is not Wednesday. It is Tuesday, December 2nd. Tuesday is coming. Did you bring your coat? Anybody tell me what that's from? I'll give you 2 shimmy points. Alright, 600 meters away. It is Tuesday in my world. In the world of Shimmy. Fine, it's Wednesday, wherever you are. Who knows the star date? Yeah, we could go by star date. But there's a website for that. Man, the frames make it slower than a slideshow. If we just go ahead and just not move the camera here, it doesn't seem as bad. It looks like it's just drifting, and the numbers are just taking a little while to update here. Also, if you'd like to know more about Shimmy World, pop on over to my channel and hit that follow button, right? Am I right? Your face is the only time zone. Later, Greg. Thanks for stopping by. Nine metros a second. Okay, let's go ahead and do a little Bernie do up in this direction. There we go. A little Bernie do in the right direction there. They currently have some... Oh, wow. That's cool. Hey, Cybertech. I saw that Kerbal Engineer had an update. I didn't take a chance to take a look. Is there anything you'd like to tell us about the latest update? Is it 0.13? Or 1.0.13? You'd like to tell us about? Or is it just 1.13? I think it was... Kerbal Engineer. If it's not, then it's something else. Wave Ray 64. Talking about Wave Ray 64 reminds me of Mario Kart 64, and I was listening to the Rainbow Road soundtrack earlier today. You know, because of good times. Remember the Rainbow Road 64 soundtrack? He was very triumphant and happy. Alright. Go ahead and wait for this thing here. Dum bum ba da. Yeah, it's 1 point, okay, and includes fixes for various reasons, sometimes that happen, which happened to DOS because he didn't update last night. Oh, okay, all right, that's fair. Thanks for letting me know. I mean, I could always just read the update and not bug you every single time I have a question. So why are we going in that direction? Not the direction we want to go in. We want to dock to that thing, so that's the only place we can dock to. So we will dock you. Because Exer, it's Japan. That's just the cool thing to do. It also shows the torque produced by offset engines and also the delta V and thrust calculated by taking... Cybertech! You're amazing! You are amazing. That is great. MechJeb used to do that. I mean, it still does, but we don't talk about MechJeb here. Except when I just mentioned it. But yeah, that's pretty cool. Looks like we're pretty much lined up to dock with this thing. At 9 frames an hour. Oh, maybe a little bit too much. There we go. Here we go. Right on target. Stay on target. Did you just hear MechJeb? See, here's the thing. I'm not the type of person that really cares. I'm not gonna get into that argument like other people do. I remember it used to be an argument, like back in the day, a couple of years ago. Well, about a year ago, year and a half maybe. People would argue about MechJeb all the time. It was awful. Basically, one way to derail any sort of thread or chat about Kerbal Space Program is mention MechJeb, and everybody just starts... it's just a bad time. I've used MechJeb. Don't like the automatic features of it, but it had a lot of information. Kerbal Engineer does have that information, too. Think about Kerbal Engineer. Kerbal Engineer is not MechJeb. And so that's what... I mean, hopefully you don't take this the wrong way, Cybertech, but I think that's one thing that... I would say a pretty big reason why it's also pretty popular, because it's basically... It's MechJeb without being MechJeb. I don't know. So... But Kerbal Engineer is an amazing mod, so. Raider Nick, you better be careful. Raider Nick. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to go ahead and transfer all the fuel from this guy into this guy. And then we are going to go ahead and discard this guy. Not this guy, but this guy right here. And so we'll need to go ahead and undock and then deorbit. You're just one guy. There's like a million people working on MechJeb. Is there? Okay. Alright, we have Doc. Or is this thing empty? No, it's not empty. It is not empty yet. Let's go and lock this. This is... Still doesn't have... fuel in it. Which is good. We don't want a habitation area with fuel inside. It's a bad place. And that's locked too. Very nice, very nice. So we go into attack fuel balancer. Oxygen, not oxygen. We want oxidizer. Doop-de-doo. And it's the 72 whatever is there. Go ahead and transfer out. There we go. Happy day. And this thing would stop doing this thing that you're seeing. I'm only clicking once. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and just. You are trying my patience. Please. Please. Please, why? Why do you gotta do this? Thank you. Okay. We're all good. We're all fine. Why are your FPS so bad? Maybe my FPS is even worse because my computer parts on the other side of the room are just kind of sapping the frames. Hello, Toxic Turtle. How's it going today? Are we delivering crew to Zog's base? Eventually. We will be eventually doing that, but we need to set up Zog's base before we do that. So, yeah. We went ahead and done this. What we'll need to do now is undock this. Actually, no. Let's go ahead and... before we do that. We brought up supplies. Remember? Remember when we brought up supplies? We had all sorts of food... let's go ahead and transfer out all the RCS and food again. Let's see. Food. Plenty of food. We might want to toss some of this food. Fuel balancer. Monopropellant. Now these are 96.24. Yeah, there we go. And see, it's doing this thing. Okay. See, barely any. Unfortunately, I brought all this stuff up here for nothing. I'm gonna have to deorbit it. Oh well. Looks like we're gonna have plenty of food here. We'll go ahead and transfer some more. Go ahead and right click on one of these. Nope. Right click on this. No. Maybe there isn't any extra food in this thing. So happy day. Oh, wait, there we go. In. Alright, we're nearly full of food again. Okay. Okie dokie. Oh yeah, I'm like really parched. I'll be back in a second. I need water. I need water for my red solo cup of power. Wire shimmy! I'm right here. Don't worry. Just calm. Calm yourself. What? I'm still here. I'm still alive. I was like, why are you guys freaking out? Alright, so what am I doing? I was going to redock the supply vessel. Oh wow, there's even more monopropel than that. Gonna redock the supply vessel to that pod there, and I'm gonna go ahead and deorbit it. Now, it is all very possible that I could, put this thing back into orbit. It might not take a lot to deorbit, but we'll see. We'll see. So here we go. At 0 frames a second here. What we'll want to do, I'm gonna dock it at that port there. So we'll go ahead and set this as a target. There we go. Go ahead and rotate it around. Chase. Oh wow, this thing has plenty of oomph to it, because it has so many RCS jets on it. Like it. I'm just gonna go ahead and navigate around our station to connect to that port there. Are we going to stop with the station montage? There's a lot of stuff going on in chat right now. I don't know what's going on. I wish I could watch, but I am playing Kerbal Space Program. Well, you've done your 2 hours, I know, right? I've done my time. I've done my time. It's time for this old man to go home. All right, where am I heading? Where am I going? So wait, you're telling me that they don't have Miku on the side of that rocket? I'm disappointed. You've let me down, Japan. Alright, let's start heading towards this thing. Hello, Brainiac. How's it going? We're just doing a little station maintenance here before we continue on. Right, redocking here in just a second. Let's go ahead and give it a slow down here. Any moment. 3, 2, 1. And, oh, I kind of booped it. Alright. Station is a little out of whack right now. Maybe after we go ahead and undock this thing, we might be able to return this thing into a more stable orbit. I don't know. It's kind of hard to tell. Now let's go ahead and undock here. And we'll go ahead and undock this. I think I did them in the wrong order, but that's fine. Come on, let me undock your face. Come on, undock. That's that. This is that. Oops, no, that's the wrong door. No, wait, okay, hang on. Control from here, please. Control from here. Thank you. There we go. Let's just push ourselves out. There we go. Get ourselves out of the way. Excuse me, please, pardon me. Just gonna go ahead and get rid of this thing. Let's go ahead and set this over to Chase. Deorbiting here in just a moment. We need to go ahead and reactivate our fuel. Why does it say we have no Delta V? Kerbal Engineer is lying to us. Yeah, we might not be able to deorbit. I don't know, it's kind of hard to say. It's telling me zero delta V. That's interesting. Well, it's no. Nary a worry, nary a worry. Oh, now it's telling me. Ah, orbital micromanagement, the bane of your space stations. Yeah, it does take a little bit. It does take a little bit of effort here. So it looks as if we might be deorbiting this thing. We do have all sorts of extra RCS. We can always launch another rocket with another one of these, or basically a larger RCS tank. We did take care of, excuse me, all the food situation. So we'll just go ahead and deorbit this thing. are we doing? Almost there. Stay on target. Almost there. Stay on target. I think once this thing gets below 20 kilometers, it'll deorbit. How far are we away? 1.8 kilometers. Okay, yeah. Let's go ahead and undock here. See how much more delta V we have. I think we can go and turn around if we'd like. If we could turn around and redock, that'd be great. But what is our... Oh, yeah, we could. Come on, let's, I can't click because everything's rotating. Come on, just let me click on something. There we... Oh, I almost had it! There we go. Relative velocity 95. Let's return. Why not? Let's just go to return. I think we can do that, can't we? I'd rather have all this extra. Well, do I want to, though? I can't make up my mind. Nah, we don't. We'll let it just do a thing. But. At least I know I could have. You know, I'm making the decision now, but I don't want to. Just because of slideshows. Okay. Now, let's go ahead and switch back to the station. Switch to... There we go. This is the reason I like Salyut Station. One or two modules for looks more than anything. Yep. Jimmy, when are you building your new computer? Right after I stop the stream, I'm going to start working on building my computer. Now it's doing the thing where it won't let me switch over. Is it this is target? No? It's gone. I've lost the ability to switch over to things. I click on it. Click on it. Click, 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 click. Funky Uncle and Tactical Twizzler. How's it going? Oh, great. Looks like I can't do the thing I need to do here, which is switch. So I'm gonna go ahead and F5. And we're just gonna go ahead and watch this thing re-enter. Oh, unfortunately, I left that thing kind of drifting, though. Rip, Shimmy's game, I know. Maybe I can switch to now. Switch to it now? No? No? Oh. Q. Cannot switch vessels while in the atmosphere. You can't tell me what to do. You're not my mom. F9 for cheats. That's kind of interesting. Rippin' pepperoni. Alright, that's satisfactory. No, let me do something! No! Well, we're stuck here. Great. Great! Great! See, it looks like it really wants to go. It's like, nope. You click on it. Nope. Okay. Well, yeah, I'm sorry to say, I think I'm going to go ahead and have a pretty short stream for what I normally do on Tuesdays and, you know, most of my rest of the days. I usually stream at least 4 hours. I try, like, 5 to 6, honestly. I'm a little tired, and I actually want to start, I'm really itching to start working on this computer thing, so I'm just going to go ahead and call it a night. We do have other streamers streaming right now. Let's go ahead and take a look here. I would say go to EJ, but I think he's almost done too. He only usually streams for 3 hours. But DOS is streaming, so if you're looking for more Kerbal Space Program, I do recommend DOS. Let's see who else we got here. Brute Force for Victory is doing, it's kind of like a Twitch Plays KSP thing. It's pretty interesting. So if you're interested in figuring out how Twitch Plays KSP thing would work, that'd be cool. And I've seen Civnet before, too. What else have we got here? Don't really know any of these other people. But, yep, plenty of other KSP streamers. Go and check them out. Sorry, I'm just going to go ahead and just call it a short stream today. Yep, kind of tired. Want to go ahead and get my computer thing working, too. So we won't have these issues as much anymore. Of course, we're still going to have bugs. If the game loads up in like 2 seconds, it's perfectly fine. It's the 10-minute well, not 10 minutes. It's like the 5-minute loading time. That's kind of a pain in the butt. So, anyway, I'm going to go run the outro, peeps. If you want to watch more Kerbal Space Program with me in it, I recommend popping over to my channel. I will be streaming roughly the same time tomorrow, hopefully with a brand new spanking new computer. If I don't stream tomorrow, then I've completely broken everything, and then, you know, be sure to, you know, picnic. So, anyway, see you all later. Peace out. Keep on questing, listeners. Once again, I'm Shimmy. See you all later. What do I do? I hit this thing, and I hit this thing.
Zero to space in 30 seconds, go. I am Dahood Left-Handed. 9 months ago, I started making videos to help me fix my stutter. The stutter improved some, but it turns out I really like making videos, so here I am now on KSPTV. Catch my stream every Wednesday at 6 p.m. Central Standard Time. That's 4 o'clock for the West Coast, 7 o'clock for the East Coast, and 2300 GMT for everywhere else. See you there.
So, just a reminder, this is Kerbal Space Program TV, KSP TV. We got all these different people to stream. Look at it. Study it. Learn it. Be amazed by it. This is who streams on this channel. It's amazing. I'm on Tuesday. So you can see right there. Today's Tuesday in my world.
Do you like rockets? What about space planes? And stranded Kerbals? But mostly stranded Kerbals. Then join me, Nitch, to start the week on KSPTV. Mondays, 3 p.m. EST, 8 p.m. BST, 11 p.m. MSK, and 5 a.m. AET.
Shall we play a game?
Yep, Poynton Rosenberg Scalabuck, he can smell, yeah! But seriously, I'm Tanuki, host of Hack Gravity. Yeah, I'm that streamer. Yeah, you know which one. Yeah, the crazy one. Anywho, come watch me, Jeb, Bob, and Bill sightsee Kerbin, go to the moon, see the solar system, or not. So catch me at my new time, Sundays at 6 p.m. Eastern, 3 p.m. Pacific, and 10 p.m. GMT on KSP TV.